Hello children, welcome to today's class. Hope all of you are fine at home. Today we are going to continue the chapter Management of Natural Resources Part 5. So hope all of you have understood the previous concepts. In the last class, I spoke about water for all and the ways to conserve water, and we have seen dams and the protests that are made against the construction of dams. So today we are going to learn something more about storing and conservations of water and various methods involved in that. So let's start our today's class. So, I told you, like, we are going to learn about water storing methods. So, water storing method, the common method to store water and the process of storing water, it is nothing but you can use a common term. You might have heard this term, that is water harvesting. You might have heard this term, water harvesting, in your previous classes. Like, let's see what is water harvesting. Water harvesting is the capture, diversion and storage of water obtained from different fresh water sources for plant irrigation, domestic purposes, industrial purposes, groundwater recharge and other uses. So here, what is this water harvesting? So water harvesting, it is nothing but it is a method of capturing or diverging, okay, or diverting this water that is obtained from different fresh water sources. The common fresh water source is nothing but, as I told you earlier, that is rainfall. So, like, the collection of this water and storing this water and using this water for different purposes like irrigation, and domestic purposes like watering your garden, and that can be used for washing the utensils, that is called as domestic purpose, and industrial purposes, and also that can be used for groundwater recharge also, I will tell you as you progress on with this chapter, and other uses. So this is the use of the water system, water harvesting system. Okay, so in short, you can say that is a collection of water and storing it and using it for different purposes like irrigation and all. So in short, you can say like this. And this slide shows the goals of water harvesting systems. So the first one can be improve living conditions. In what way, I'll be telling you. Substitute groundwater, reduce flood risk, reduce soil erosion risk, recharge groundwater. So these are the main goals of water harvesting. So I will tell you like how these goals are fulfilled by water harvesting systems. So the most important concept in this water harvesting is watershed management. So what is this watershed management? So what is watershed? So we can say like watershed, it is nothing but it is like a big water source, you can say. See, like various sources of water like rivers, lakes and all combined together form a single big area filled with water, and that is nothing but watershed. So that is a natural watershed. So watershed can be of two types, like you have natural and artificial. Like the man-made one is like artificial watershed, and the natural one is like combining of all the rivers at a particular point, and from this particular point the water is diverged to all necessary areas, okay, by man, or naturally it can be done. So this is nothing but actually watershed. So here we are speaking about this watershed management. What is this watershed management actually mean? So it is the process of creating, implementing plans, program and projects to sustain and enhance watershed functions that affect the plant and animal and human communities within a watershed boundary. So here I told you like it is like a collection of water in a particular land. So this watershed management, it is as I told you in your earlier class, like there is mismanagement of water. And you also saw that there is no proper equitable distribution of water to all the people in the country. So here actually this management, watershed management, gives an equitable distribution of water to entire part of the to all the regions, to all the people, like water will be equitably distributed. It is equally distributed by following the, like by managing the water systems. Now this watershed management, it is nothing but actually like it is like creating plans, programs and projects to sustain and enhance watershed functions. So watershed, I told you already, it is a area filled with water. So you are implementing certain plans, or you are implementing certain projects, or you are implementing certain programs in order to enhance the watershed functions. And this enhancement will clearly affect the plant, animal and human communities within that area. See how I'll tell you. Like this is the actual definition, I'll tell you how. So like why is this watershed management useful? So watershed management is the integrated use of land, vegetation and water in a geographically discrete drainage area for the benefit of its residents, with the objective of protecting or conserving the hydrologic services that the watershed provides and of reducing or avoiding negative downstream or groundwater impacts. You might be like, you feel a little bit complicated to understand the language, but once I explain, you will understand that. So here this watershed management is nothing but it is the integrated use of land, vegetation and water in a geographically discrete drainage area. That means actually, see for example, rainwater. So simply if you leave that rainwater as it is without concern, it runs off or it forms a puddle or something. It is wasted unnecessarily. Here watershed, it is nothing but actually they make certain ponds and rainwater is collected there, or water that is coming from various sources is collected in a particular area, and the nearby areas are connected with that area filled with water, okay, by pipes or something, and wherever necessary, like for agriculture or domestic use, or it can be used for recharging this groundwater and all, this water is sent whenever it is required, okay. So that is nothing but watershed management, using the water in a more efficient way. Okay, so at the time of rainfalls especially, or even the collection point, common collection point, sometimes people nearby will not get that water. So they have to walk meters, kilometers or kilometers and kilometers in order to get that water. So here this watershed management, as I told you, like this is connected to different parts of the region that is situated nearby that watershed. So you call that area like the area in which like it is located nearby a watershed. That is nothing but a watershed community, so that the people can use the water, and they can use the water for irrigation purposes, and even the cattle can use that, even the household needs can be fulfilled by this water. So this is the main aim of this watershed management. So what is the main aim of this is, it is protecting or conserving the hydrologic services, mainly water. It is conserving the water, okay, and also even like a negative downstream, in the sense when there is no proper vegetation. Nowadays you can see deforestation is getting increased, and so due to this, the holding capacity of soil is getting reduced. And so what is happening, the downstream of water is increasing day by day, year by year, and due to this, the topsoil is getting eroded and the water is simply getting wasted without getting percolated into the ground, nor it cannot be used by the people also. So even this watershed management, it is avoiding this negative downstream and also groundwater impacts. So thereby collecting the water in a particular area, and this can be used, this can be supplied to different regions situated nearby that watershed. Okay, so this is how watershed management is organized. And here the fresh water and fresh water ecosystem is the most basic components of watershed management. As I told you, rainwater, you can say that is a fresh water, or you say different lakes and all combined together to form a major water source. So these are the basic components of watershed management. So let's see the objectives of watershed management. As I told you, some points I've discussed in the previous slide, it is used for maintaining the balance, it is used to conserve the water. And apart from that, you have several advantages with this, or aims, or the objectives of watershed management. So the first one is to control damaging runoff and degradation, and thereby conservation of soil and water. As I told you, due to deforestation, all of the topsoil is becoming loose. As the rain is falling down onto this ground, what is happening is, along with rainwater, the topsoil is also getting eroded. That is what is called soil erosion, as you all know that. And even to control this damaging runoff, that is nothing but a runoff. Okay. So here, to control the damaging runoff and degradation, and thereby conserving the soil and water. And the second one is to manage and utilize the runoff water for useful purpose. And here the runoff water is getting collected, right? And it is supplied to various purposes. So this is one more aim. And the third one is to protect, conserve and improve the land of watershed for more efficient and sustained production. For more efficient and sustained production is, see, whenever you are conserving and improving the area, watershed, what happens is, it is giving more access to, this water is used more for agriculture, or this water is used by household people, or this can be used by industries. Especially what is happening here is, they are stopping the usage of groundwater, okay, and they're not depleting the groundwater reserves. As they are using this water that is stored in the in a particular area. So what they are doing is, here the agriculture productivity is increased, as well as the industrial productivity is increased everywhere. They have their own uses. Apart from this, they are saving the ground water especially. Okay, so this is how it is it is what is actually told in this point. And next point is to protect and enhance the water resource originating in the watershed. So the same concept is repeated here, even the same thing, to protect and enhance the water resource originating in the watershed. Even it is conserving the water resources, especially groundwater. So here we are speaking about groundwater. And also here, watershed management, it is nothing but you have many more advantages. As I told you, this water, since it is used in agriculture, especially at the time of scarcity of water, also this water can be used in agriculture, and there will be more crop production. Okay, and thereby the trees also increases, and thereby they hold the topsoil firmly, and thereby prevent the soil from getting eroded. In this way, they are preventing the soil erosion also, and even the trees are it is helpful for afforestation. So the major points will be seen in the next slide. So to check soil erosion, as I told you, and to reduce the effect of sediment yield on the watershed. So sediment yield is nothing but, I told you, runoff water is collected. So when there is no proper vegetation on the land, the water also carries some soil particles along with it, right? So as the water is collected, it also brings the soil particles, and the sediment is more and more. So what is happening due to this watershed management? I told you, afforestation is done, and so the sediment yield also gets reduced. Got the concept? So that is how it is done. And next is to rehabilitate the deteriorating land, the spoiled lands or the barren lands again turns into greens. Okay. And to moderate the floods peak at the downstream areas. So here, like I told you, especially here, the major concept is deforestation. So since there is no since there are no trees, what is happening? The water, like especially at the time of floods, it in the downstream areas, like in a slanting way, on the slopes and all, the water, it goes down more forcibly. Okay. So this watershed management, it reduces the floods peaks at the downstream areas, especially in the slopy areas. The floods, I mean, the rate of movement of water gets reduced. And next is to reduce infiltration of, sorry, to increase infiltration of rainwater. Infiltration is nothing but absorption capacity, okay, by the soil. Next is to improve and increase the production of timbers, fodder and wildlife resource. So obviously, due to this watershed management, water is used in a more effective way. Obviously, trees are grown properly and you get a lot of timber, you get a lot of fodder. And also, depending on this, wildlife is also conserved. Okay, they get food to eat. Even forests are the areas, like they are the habitats for various wildlife, right? So in this way, like wildlife production also increases. And next one is to enhance the groundwater recharge, as I told you, wherever applicable. So here we stop, obviously, the usage of groundwater, or the groundwater can be recharged by the using of this stored water. I will tell you how it is done. Okay. So these are the main aims of watershed management. And next is methods of water harvesting. So what are the methods involved in this water harvesting? So the first one is digging pits, ponds, lakes, etc. Second one is building small earthen dams or concrete check dams. So even dams are main sources of storing water, and also building small earthen dams. So here small earthen dams are nothing but you can say they are juniors to this dams. So you know, dams and reservoirs are very, very big, and earthen dams are nothing but they are can be done in low cost, and even barriers, you could say, yeah, dams are constructed with the material that is available from the earth, like soil, clay, okay, the mixture of all these materials that is available in the earth is constructed in the form of a dam, like a mini dam, okay, and there the water is conserved. And the third one is construction of dikes. So dikes, you can say the other word for dikes is embankments, okay. So embankments, construction of embankments. And the fourth one is construction of reservoirs. So construction of rooftop collecting units in houses. I think you are familiar with this fifth method, okay. So rainwater harvesting, we say, okay. So these are the methods of water harvesting. Next, coming to components of rainwater harvesting. So the major components of rainwater harvesting are catchment, delivery, storage. So this catchment, catchment, it is nothing but the surface area which is taking up the rainwater, okay. The surface area that is taking up the rainwater is called as catchment. So when we talk about rooftop harvesting systems, the rooftop is the catchment. If we dig pits and all, the pit is the collection point, right? So that pit is called as the catchment. So any surface that is responsible for taking up of water is called as catchment. And delivery, it is nothing but delivery can be pipes, okay. So the tubes that are responsible for taking up the area from the catchment to the collection point, okay. To the storage tanks, right? The third one is storage. As you all know, the tanks that are present at the bottom of the soil, or you say at the rooftop or something, that is the storage. Okay, so these are the major components of rainwater harvesting. So listen, actually these points are not there in your textbook. These are the basic things that are, by this time you might have known about these topics, but since I need to revise the concepts again, I'm telling you the previous things. Actually, this is not there in your present 10th class book, but for the basic knowledge, I'm giving you all these points, right? So please make a note of all these points. All these are not there in your textbooks. So next is different methods of water harvesting. So you can see six pictures. You can see they are digging the underground, area. They will, construct few earthen dams or something. In the second one, you can see like water is collected in a particular area. Third one also, even the fourth picture also, you can see in the fifth picture, like you can see embankments, right? You can see embankments are constructed in order to store this water. Even the sixth picture also, it shows how water is harvested. Okay, so these are the different methods of water harvesting. So next, coming to models of rainwater harvesting. So you have basically two main models of rainwater harvesting, usually that is done in India. The first one is rural model and the second one is urban model. So by the name itself, you can say rural model is the traditional method and urban is the modern method. Okay. So in today's class, we are going to see the urban models. So here, urban model of RWH. RWH is rainwater harvesting. So it is more modernized system of rainwater harvesting. The main components of urban model are roof catchment, as I told you, gutters. So gutters are nothing but actually, when you talk about this roof top, so the rooftop is the catchment. So there the water is falling and from that roof it should be passed into the pipes. So this gutters are nothing but, these gutters are like funnels that are attached to the pipes. This rainwater from the catchment enters into the gutters and from the gutters they enter into the pipes. So next is downpipe. So next one is first flush pipe. So this first flush pipe, it is nothing but the first rainwater. So as soon as the rain falls on the rooftop, okay, this first water, it enters the gutter and then to the downpipe. And as this rainwater is a fresh one, like you have many contaminants on the roof, even in the pipes also, they get stuck in the pipes. So this water, the first initial water that is coming, like that is falling on the catchment, is the first flush. Okay, so this first flush pipe, it is responsible for taking up the first flush, okay, that is filled with contaminants and all, and this first flush pipe flushes out this wastewater and it allows the remaining fresh water to enter into the storage tank. So in this way it is used. And next is a filter unit in order to filter the contaminants. And next is a storage tank and next is a collection pit. So all, as you all know all these things. And next here you can see you have a storage tank, you have pipe system. So here storage tank, it can be underground or it can be built with some, you can use a PVC tank. So you have Sintex tanks and all, so that water can be collected there. And you have underground, you can make some, underground pits, and that can be covered with concrete slabs, right? So the rainwater can be collected. That is the storage tank. In the right picture, you can see pipes that is used for these are the delivery pipes. Usually these pipes are made up of PVC, so PVC is of good quality and it is durable also. It is resistant also to heat and all. So PVC pipes are used. And next is this is what I told you in this picture. You don't have a clear thing, right? You have a percolation pipe, recharge well, so collection chamber. Next slide I'll show you. Yes, so here you can see the top rooftop is the catchment. You can see the gutter, that is like a funnel thing. And next is the downtake pipe and next is the storage tank. Okay, and this storage tank, you can put it like that or you can also excess water can be taken up further by delivery pipelines to the bottom. You can see blue color line, so left to that blue color line you have a pipe that is nothing but first flush. I told you first flush is removed by the first flush pipe. Okay, so the next one is filter. So the rainwater that is collected from the rooftop, it is like passed through the filter, and from the filter the pure water is collected in the collection pit. Okay, so from the storage tank, right, it is actually filled in the storage tank, and from the storage tank it is like entering into the filter, and from the filter it is taken into the collection pit. So this collection pits are usually connected with a motor, and that can be used by the household people for various household purposes. And also this water present in the collection pit is also used to recharge. Okay, so this is how like rainwater harvesting is done. So I want to tell you one more thing. Like nowadays we are in a concrete world, right? So due to this population, as I told you, due to the increase in the population, deforestation is also increased. To meet the needs of the people, various trees are cut. In order to live somewhere, we are like cutting the trees and making like covering the soil with concrete. Okay, and thereby what is happening here, since we are covering the land with concrete, okay, since we are covering the land with concrete, percolation of water is not done. So the ground water recharge is replenished. Yes or no? I told you in your previous class, like there are like your degradation of this groundwater. So what is happening to this groundwater? So when you don't have proper groundwater reserves, motors don't work, right? So you have pumps, bore wells, they don't work. It is due to the degradation of this groundwater. So when you save water, okay, so when you save water by rain water harvesting, by certain methods like rain water harvesting, what you are doing, you are collecting water and you are using that water for your household purpose or agriculture or something. So here you are not using groundwater, and this in some way it is helping the replenishment of groundwater. So apart from this, like what if the land is covered with concrete? So what in, especially in urban areas, how they are following this rainwater harvesting systems is like near to a bore well, they are just digging a pit. Okay, the water from the rooftop is collected in the collection pit, and as you draw water from the pumps or bore wells, the groundwater is immediately recharged with the water present in the collection pit. So here, like in urban areas also, water can be conserved by this rainwater system. So here finally, rainwater system is useful mainly in the urban areas where the, so especially in areas like which are having scarcity of water. Okay, so which are having scarcity of water, like they can use this stored water for various purposes. So at the time of scarcity also, water can be used, that is stored, and agricultural production increases, and here the primary resources and the secondary resources are also increased. So primary resources are nothing but trees and all, secondary resources are nothing but humans, wildlife and all. So since we feed on the plants, obviously animals and humans also survive. So this is how water shed management or water harvesting is very, very important. So save water, okay, and so this is how, so you can see in this picture also, so wiser. Okay, so even like nowadays in like in your TV also, you are getting certain ads regarding saving water. So saving water is a very, very important aspect in order to have a bright future and bright world. That's it for today's class. In the next class, we'll be seeing the traditional methods of water harvesting systems. Thank you.